And yeah, even if you don't believe that, believe what I said earlier. That anything that anybody else gives you materially or anything that somebody tries to make you buy is a step down from yourself. You are beautiful. God has made the best gift to the world in the world, meaning you. You start from that, then everything else has a perspective. And I love y'all for that. Matter of fact, if you can write down my email address, I ran out of cards. It's simply MrChuck@rapstation.com. All right, you can go to publicenemy.com and find it on there somewhere. But it's MrChuck@rapstation.com. Number two, if any producers, songwriters, artists out there, rappers, get your MySpaces popping. This opportunity wasn't here 10 years ago. Get your YouTube. Look, all you beat makers and producers and artists, if you're not shooting videos and learning how to cut videos, then you're not doing the best that you can do. I don't want to hear about you over a beat trying to do, no, shoot videos, people. Shoot videos. How many of y'all got a little camcorder? Now they got camcorders for $100 a target. Learn how to shoot them and cut them and make your own videos, because nobody is really paying full attention to just half the offering, and that's the audio sound. Learn how to shoot. There was a young sister yesterday at Braddock that she had a camera and was shooting with a camera. I said, hey, shoot and cut and learn how to cut. Hey, about the music and the record business dried up. It dried up because they said, you know what, they blame it on young people. They said, man, they downloading too much. They ain't buying no CDs. CDs do sell. They're called Blink. Hey, you know, hey, straight up and down, you know older people up here say, yeah, I got Blank CDs. I got Marvin Gaye's Greatest Hits. I got People Price, Earth, Wind & Fire. I got Lil Bit YouTube of the Enemy. Yeah, I got a stack of Blank CDs. Matter of fact, I don't even know how to do that, man. But my son, he know how to burn them CDs. So CDs are selling. I just say, number one, you want to get in this music business, same thing with sports. One thing about sports, coaches are telling you whether you're going to get in there or not. Doesn't mean you can't participate. If you're 4'1", you can't be the center on your basketball team. I'm sorry. You can still play, but you got to figure out what your position will be. And if you ain't on the team, learn how to do like Scottie Pippen. Start out as a water boy or something, you're still acting with the team. But in music, there ain't coaches. There ain't enough history being known. If you study black music, you get black history by default, people, automatically. Because our history is all in our music. We right here where? We at what theater? At what theater?
Billy Strayhorn.
And do we know who Billy Strayhorn is?
Yes.
And do young people know who Billy Strayhorn is?
Yes.
So it's up for y'all to tell your Billy Strayhorn, you know, that he's a little bit just as prestigious in their mind as T-Pain is right now. Or Chris Brown. So don't leave it up to them to try to figure it out or Google it. You let them know who Billy Strayhorn is. He went right to what?
Westinghouse.
There it is. Hey, it ain't about me. I came in and stepped into history right here. So it ain't like I gave y'all history. Y'all already got it. I'm damn near irrelevant at this point. Tonight, we're going to let everybody else that represent the hood do their thing. And I like to say, don't clap for me. Clap for yourself. But I'm proud of y'all, and especially the young people in the house, because y'all...